हेलो एवरीवन, आई एम प्रोफेसर सुनीता यादव फ्रॉम विजन स्कूल ऑफ मैनेजमेंट चित्तौड़गढ़ राजस्थान. द कॉन्सेप्ट दैट वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न टुडे इज़ वन ऑफ द मोस्ट इम्पॉर्टेंट कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ फाइनेंशियल मैनेजमेंट, दैट इज टाइम वैल्यू ऑफ मनी. मनी हैज़ टाइम वैल्यू एंड द रिकग्निशन ऑफ टाइम वैल्यू ऑफ मनी इन फाइनेंशियल मैनेजमेंट इज एक्सट्रीमली इम्पॉर्टेंट. So before we go further, let's understand what do we mean by time value of money. The time value of money says that the worth of a rupees received today is more than the worth of a rupees to be received in future. So if we are given a choice to choose between the two options, that is receiving rupees 100 today and another receiving rupees 100 after years, obviously most of the people would like to choose the option first. Because first, if we receive 100 today, obviously we can satisfy our present needs which are awaiting from long time, which may be awaiting from long time. Second, there is always a risk associated with the receipt of money in future. The source through which the money that we will receive in future may go bankrupt. So the people want to avoid this risk. And third, and the most important reason behind receiving the money today or preference for receiving the money today is the purchasing power of the money. The purchasing power of the money get reduced over a period of time. That is why most of the people in the world prefer to receive today rather than some other time in future, as the value of the same amount are different if they are received at different point of time. So can we compare the two cash flows occurring at the different point of time? Obviously, the answer would be no. So what should we do then in order to make them comparable? To make them comparable, we should bring their values at a common point of time. In order to have a logical and meaningful comparison between cash flow that result in different time period, it is necessary to convert the sum of money to a common point of time. And for this, we have two techniques. The one is compounding technique, that means finding out the future value of the present money. And the another is discounting technique, in which we try to find out the present value of the future money or the present value of the money that is to be received in future. So let's start to learn these techniques one by one. First, we will start with the compounding techniques. Compounding technique is used to find the future value of all cash flow at the end of a time horizon at a particular rate of interest. Suppose if we deposit rupees 1000 in a bank at 10% interest rate, at the end of the year we will receive rupees 100 as an interest and the principal amount as it was 1000. So in total we are going to receive rupees 1100. So how we can find it with the use of formula? In compounding technique, there may be three scenarios where we need to find out the future value of some cash flows. The very first one is to find out the value of a single cash flow. Suppose if we deposit rupees 5000 in a bank today and want to find its value after 5 years from now, at 10% interest rate, this can be the best example for single cash flow. The second is to find out the future value of multiple cash flow. In real business, the cash flow occurs at different time periods are different. So it is known as perpetuity, the different amount of cash flow occurring at different point of time. In compounding technique, we also have a method to calculate the future value of this perpetuity. And the third one is annuity. Actually, annuity means the cash flow of equal amount at equal interval of time. For this also, we have a method to find its future value. The future value of a lump sum amount or a single cash flow can be calculated by using a following formula, which is FV is equal to P into 1 plus I power n, where FV is future value, P is the principal amount that we deposit, and I is rate of interest operating in the economy, and n is number of years for which we want to find out the future value. So let's try to learn the application of this formula by taking an example. Here is an illustration given for its explanation. Calculate the future value of rupees 50 at the end of 3 years at 12% per annum rate of interest. Here it is given that we are depositing, or we want to find out the future value of rupees 50,000 at the end of 3 years if 12% of interest rate per annum is operating in the economy. So it is a case of single cash flow, and for solving single cash flow, or to find out the future value of a single cash flow, we have formula FV is equal to P 1 plus I power n. So here P, the principal amount that we want for which the future value is to be calculated, is 50,000, and rate of interest is 12%. The time value, or the value of n over here, is 3 years. After putting the values in this equation, we are getting 70,250. So this 50,000 will go rise to 70,250 after 3 years from now. So this is how we calculate the future value of a single cash flow. So far we have considered only the future value of a single cash flow, but in real business we may come with many examples, or we will face many situations where the cash flow occurs in different amount and at different time period. So in order to find out their future value, we have the formula to find out the future value of perpetuity. In perpetuity also we may have two cases. The one is if the perpetuity occurs at the beginning of the year, and the second is if the perpetuity occurs at the end of the year. So let's start learning to find out the future value of perpetuity, which is occurring at the end of the year. And the formula for to find out the future value of the perpetuity is future value is equal to P1 into 1 plus I power n minus 1 plus P2 into 1 plus I power n minus 2, and so on until and unless it reaches to P into 1 plus I power 0. Here again, the subscripts which has been used in this formula, FV is future value, P1 is the cash flow occurring at the end of the period year 1, P2 cash flow of the year 2, P3 cash flow at the year 3, and so on. So let's apply the formula in a question where we need to find out the future value of perpetuity. Here is the illustration 2 given, where we need to determine the future value at the end of 5 years for the following payment or following series of cash flow at 8% interest rate. So here we are depositing at the end of first year rupees 1000, at the end of second year rupees 2000, third year rupees 3000, fourth year rupees 4000, and at the end of fifth year it is rupees 5000. Now if we want to find out the future value of this series of cash flow which is occurring at the end of every year, obviously we will use the formula, which is FV, future value, is equal to P1 into 1 plus I power n minus 1 plus P2 into 1 plus I power n minus 2, and so on. So here we can see that P1 is the cash flow which is occurring at the end of the first year, and here it is 1000. Second year is P2, the P2 is 2000, P3 is 3000, P4 is 4000, and P5 is
5000. So now we can easily put the values in the formula and we can calculate the future value of the perpetuity as explained in the example. Now let's take the second case where perpetuity is occurring at the beginning of the year. Now let's want to find out the future value of a perpetuity where the cash flow is occurring at the beginning of the year. And for this, the formula is future value is equal to P1 into 1 plus I power n plus P2 into 1 plus I power n minus 1. And so on until it reaches to Pn into 1 plus I power 1. Here again, FV is future value, P1 is the cash flow at the beginning of year 1, P2 is the cash flow occurring at the beginning of year 2, and so on. I is for rate of interest and N is for number of years. Now it's time to learn to find out the future value of an annuity. Before we start to find out the future value of annuity, let's first understand what actually the annuity is. When the cash flow occurs at the end of each period in equal amount, then it is known as annuity. Most of the insurance companies take the premium from the customer for any insurance policy, and these premiums are in equal amounts, and we need to deposit the amounts at equal interval of time. That can be monthly, quarterly, or yearly, or it can be anything. That is a perfect example of annuity. So if we want to find out the future value of annuity, for that we have a formula where future value of annuity is equal to A divided by I whole multiplied by 1 plus I power n minus 1, where again FV is future value, A is the annuity or yearly payment. If we talk in this example, it would be the premium to a insurance company. I is rate of interest, N is number of years for which we are depositing the amount. So let's try to find out the future value of annuity in an illustration. Here one example is given where Mr. X deposit rupees 10,000 at the end of every year for next 4 years, and his deposit earn a compound interest of 10% per annum. Determine how much money he will have at the end of 4 years. Here we can see that he is depositing rupees 10,000 every year for next 4 years, and the interval at which he is depositing is 1 year. So amounts are equal, intervals are equal. It is the perfect case of annuity. And we already discussed the formula to find out the future value of annuity. So after putting the values into the formula, we will get an amount which is equal to 46,410. So the value of annuity would be 46,410 at the end of year. That means this much amount would be accumulated in his account at the end of 4th year. So now we are done with the future values of single cash flow, annuities, and perpetuity. Now it's time to learn the discount technique, or to learn to find out the present value of a future amount. For this, we use the discount techniques, and here also three scenarios may occur where we need to find out the present value of a single cash flow, the present value of multiple cash flow, and the present value of annuity. So let's first understand how to find out the present value of a single cash flow. The present value of a sum of money received after n years can be calculated by using the following formula, that is, present value is equal to A upon 1 plus I power n. Here, PV is again present value, A is the amount at the end of period n, and I is rate of interest, n is time in years. We can understand this formula by using a practical example. So let's take an example where Mr. X is to receive from Indra Vikas Patra rupees 20,000 after 5 years from now. His time preference for money is 10% per annum. Calculate the present value. Here, a cash inflow is occurring at the end of 5 years, that is rupees 20,000. It is just a single cash flow occurring after 5 years from now. Here, the value of N would be 5 years, and the rate of interest is 10% per annum. Now, as we know, the present value is equal to A upon 1 plus I power N. Here, the value of A, which is the future amount that he's going to receive after 5 years, is 20. And all the other values like I and R are given. So, we can easily find out the present value of 20,000 for today, which would be equal to 12,420. So let's understand how to calculate the present value of multiple cash flow. We can also say the present value of perpetuity. Here the cash flow occurs in different amount and at different time periods. We will understand this by using an example, by taking an example. Here we can see that we have taken an example where four cash flows are occurring. For the first year, it is 20,000. For second year, we are receiving 40,000. In third year, 20,000. And in fourth year, 10,000. So now we will solve this question or this example. Here we can see that we need to find out the present value of different cash flow. So first we need a rate of interest. Let's assume the rate of interest in the economies is 8% per year compounded annually. So here first we need to find out the discounting factors, and the formula for discounting factor is 1 upon 1 plus r power n. For the first year it would be 1 upon 1 plus 0.08 power 1, which is equal to 926, and so on. We can calculate for all 4 years. Once we will find the present value factor at the rate of interest 8% for different year, we will multiply the present value factor with the cash inflows and in order to get the present value of each cash flow. Once we will be done with that, we will add all the present values and we will get the total present value of the series of cash flow is equal to 76,030. Now we will learn how to find out the value of present value of annuity. As we know that annuity is a series of equal cash flow occurring at different interval of time. So in order to find out the present value of an annuity, the formula that would be used is present value is equal to A upon I whole multiplied by 1 minus 1 divided by 1 plus I power n. Here again, A is the amount at the end of the period n, I is rate of interest occurring in the economy, n is for number of years, and PV is present value. So in order to understand this formula, we will use another example and we will try to find out the present value of a series of equal series of cash flow. So this is all about the time value of money. Thank you.